we live?
We are live.
Hey everybody, how you doing? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I had to say that because a lot of these videos get shared. If you have not been following the story of Kobe, we feature a lot of dogs here, but a lot of people have been taking interest in Kobe and the next step for Kobe. Kobe is a definitely bites humans, goes after humans. He's a big resource guarder as well of humans. This is the fourth time that I've actually worked with him. I actually don't work with the dogs. John is his trainer, Brittany is his trainer, and Jordan is his trainer, so I'm sort of a stranger. So he has zero comfort factor with me. I mean, he's got zero relationship with me. If you've been watching the progress that we've been making as far as me approaching, I've done it from different distances. This time what we're going to do is, John's going to have him step up onto this, I'm going to give him physical touch, and then I'm going to click and then reward. So I'm rewarding for the fact that he came in close, I gave him physical touch. Just a few weeks ago, this would have gotten me attacked. Absolutely would have gone after me. If you want to go back about 3 weeks, 4 weeks to the intake video, you can just see just the movement of somebody else will make this dog lunge and bite. So remember, you're seeing a dog that's a lot calmer right now, but if you watch the intake video, you'll see the dog, you know, how we got the dog. So here we go. I'll do a little bit of Q&A after this. I also want to bring out another dog that we're going to put on Periscope after this, the dog that came in yesterday, because I really want to have a really good conversation with everybody out there just about the level of the dog that comes in here and the level of the dogs that we have. So here we go.
Go, Kobe. Go say hi.
Go ahead.
So by having him go onto this, it puts him right in the right area that I want.
Go ahead. Good boy.
And he's looking to John a lot. I don't need him to be looking at me. John's his trainer. That's fine. I have no relationship with this dog whatsoever, nor do I need to. This is not something the owners will most likely do.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
So John has been clicking and treating him. We're using the dog's daily food. On most of his stuff, he's off of the clicker, but we're training him something new. So a clicker is a marker.
Let's go, Kobe. Let's say hi.
Go ahead, boy.
Don't throw up in my shoes. I need to throw up on my shoes.
Let's go,
Cubs. Do this a couple more times, then we'll do a little bit of Q&A. But again, one more level, one small little piece, just one small little piece into this dog's rehab, and we like to be as transparent as possible, and this is what we've been spending. We talk about punishment all the time. Has Kobe been punished for going after a staff member? Absolutely. How long did that take? 1 second, 2 seconds. 99.9% of Kobe's board and train here has literally been like yes stuff. It's been challenging the dog to do more and more things and getting them excited about working. So that's the mixture. But without that no, you're not going to get here. You're not going to get here at all. So let's go.
Go, Kobe. Say hi. Kobe. Go ahead. Let's go. Kobe. Touch. Touch.
Go ahead.
Kobe, touch.
Go ahead. Good job.
And even though I clicked when he was walking away from me, that's fine. All right.
Good job, Kobe.
Good. So that's what we're going to do with Kobe right now. I'll do a little bit of Q&A, and then I want to bring out a dog. Did you even handle that dog yet that came in yesterday?
Yeah, I handled it.
All right, good. Let's bring out a brand new dog. Is it going to be muzzled or unmuzzled?
Probably be muzzled.
Muzzled. But I want to really have a conversation, a really honest, transparent conversation about pretty much kudos to my staff about the work they're doing. So let me just do a little bit of Q&A. I'll take the camera.
Awesome. Thanks. This is Dan.
Hi,
awesome kennel staff. So any questions at all about what we just did? And if you've been following us on... The thing about him standing on the platform, it just gave him an exact. It just gave him a. It gave him a spot to stand. So it gave him. He knows what that is, but you can tell he was a little bit concerned about like being that close to me. But it just gave him an identifiable spot where to go. So that's why we did that. Good question, though. Good question. So you can do that a lot. That's also really good for people that if they've got dogs that recall and then run into them, you can teach the dog to recall to you and then stand on that so that way they don't run into you. That's another little tip that you can also use that for. You can use it as place if you want to. That's a sport. A lot of sport dog folks do that to do swing finishes, to do competition healing, to do dogs that like when they're in heel and the human moves, the dog moves with them. That's a very that's what they use as well. And that actually came from Tractor Supply. It's a grain. It's a livestock feeding bowl. It's made out of rubber. All right. So thanks for everybody for checking in and for watching. That was really, really great. Hold on one second. How would you desensitize a dog to rowdy children? Teach the dog a default command, such as place, and then have lots of kids running around. We do that here. We've shown many videos of my kids doing that. So once you teach a dog place or down or heel, and then around distractions, you can add kids to that as well. That was great. Thank you. Was the touch command used for just setting up a protocol like this for Kobe? Yeah. Yep. But touch can also be on a hand. You can use touch on a hand, touch on a target stick, touch on a target. You can do that. Can you show a video of putting on a muzzle for aggressive defensive dog? We can. There's a dog here that came in yesterday, and it actually went after Brittany the first 5 minutes that was here. It slipped its muzzle, and we had to put its muzzle off, put its muzzle back on. So we missed that opportunity. Maybe tomorrow I can show putting the muzzle on. But the dog, I don't think, was fighting the muzzle today. If the dog fights the muzzle, that's really, really challenging. It's really challenging to do. It's not easy. So sometimes it takes two people to do. There's a bunch of different ways to do it. Ideally, we want dogs to be muzzle conditioned prior to them coming here if they've got a human bite history. Dog bite history, you don't have to worry about it. Human bite history, you absolutely have to worry about it because the act of you trying to put a muzzle on will get the dog to attack you. If some dogs, if you're concerned that there's going to be a bite, some dogs, Megan, they've never bitten, but they've also never had put pressure on them. They've never had pressure put on them. So what is pressure? It could be anything from if you say a command and you enforce the command to spatial pressure to environmental pressure. But if you feel that there's going to be a bite on a human or a redirection on a human, it's always a good idea to muzzle the dog. It also depends on your leash handling skills. So did you initially teach him to ignore people and exist around? Kobe, pretty much, we're teaching him, yes, to ignore everybody. And we're going to want him to, even after this, the dog is 2 years old, a little bit more than two. So we're going to want him to pretty much be neutral, to ignore all people for now. There's no reason why a dog that has a history of resource guarding and going after humans to like be lovey-dovey with humans. The first step is existence, Rachel. So the first step is going to be existence. That would be the goal, especially after a board and train. Eventually, will the dog be great around people? Most likely. I mean, it's only 2 years old. It's got a good 10 years left of its life. Michelle, would you start a dog farther away from a stranger if they have problems with pressure and slowly move? Yes, I did, Michelle. I showed that 2 Facebook Lives ago. How did I know Kobe was ready? Educated guess. So we pushed him farther. So I came in today knowing that I wanted to do that. And we just, it was an educated guess that the dog was ready. It just felt right. We've worked with so many dogs with bite histories, so many aggressive dogs. It just felt right to do it. And John's here. It's a Sunday. I had some extra time, so we did it. Owners putting on a muzzle is differently, but if you muzzle condition the dog and you give it a command, it becomes much, much easier. But yes, you're right. Yes, you're right. A dog can attack you. So many dogs attack you when you try to put the muzzle on. So many dogs attack you when you try to put the muzzle on. But if the dog is properly muzzle conditioned, at least it gives you a little bit of an edge. It gives you a little bit of an edge. We like Baskerville muzzles, Lily. Baskerville muzzles are the one you'll probably see this dog come out on now. They go from a size 0 to, I think, a 6. So we like the Baskerville muzzles. If a dog doesn't have a bite history, I don't like to use muzzles. And if a dog is not human aggressive, we don't want to use muzzles. Muzzles are pressure sources. Muzzles are pressure sources, so it creates pressure on a dog. It also sometimes gets dogs to be a little bit of like, this really sucks, I hate having the muzzle on. So you don't usually get your best work out of a dog that's muzzled, but it's really good. Any biting dog, it's good. It's really, really good to have a dog love the muzzle. More fearful than aggressive. The dog was more probably of a resource guarder than anything else. The bottom line is, though, aggression, you don't want, a bite's a bite's a bite. Always remember that. So if a dog bites you, it bit you. It bit you. Obviously, there's a lot of fear that goes on throughout these dogs, but there's also a lot of learned behaviors of by not stopping a lot of the triggers that lead to aggression. What I always definitely want to state is everyone thinks they assume that a dog was beaten, that's why it's aggressive. That's a lie. That's just a lie. All right, so I'm going to end it right there because I've got this new dog out who's looking much, much better than yesterday already. Definitely better energy. It's doing much better. So I'm going to do a Periscope on this dog. All right. Hey, Canada, how are you? Marie, how you doing? All right, take care. The leash doesn't matter. The leash doesn't matter. Any leash you want. Any leash you want. You can do a slip lead if you want. Do a thin nylon leash, thin leather leash. The leash doesn't matter. Well, the leash wouldn't matter if the dog was aggressive or not aggressive. It's a leash. You can use a shoelace if you want to. Okay? Just get a basic leash. All right? Okay. Take care. Bye-bye. You're not shutting off.